Hi, I'm Chris Breen with another Macworld video tip. In this movie, I'm going to show you how to create a couple of useful Automator workflows. We'll start with one that, with a simple drag and drop, allows you to compress and email a file. It goes like this. First thing, you have to launch Automator, which we'll do from Spotlight. When Automator first launches, you'll see the template chooser sheet. In this case, we're going to choose Application, and then click the Choose button. And here's your workflow window, with libraries of actions on the left, next to it, the actions within each library, and then finally, the workflow area. We'll start by selecting the Files and Folder library. In the Actions area, drag the Create Archive action to the workflow area. We'll leave the settings as they are, which is to use the same name as the original file, and save the compressed archive to the desktop. Now select the Mail library, and we'll drag the new mail message action into the workflow area. If you'd like, you can pre-address messages in this action, something you might do if you routinely send compressed files to the same person. And finally, from this same mail library, drag in the add attachment to front message action. Now save your workflow to the desktop and give it an intuitive name. Now let's take a look at it. To invoke your workflow, all you have to do is drag a file or folder that you'd like to compress onto the app and watch what happens. So here's our test file. I drag it on top of my workflow. Workflow launches, mail launches, and here's my new message with the compressed file attached. At this point, all I have to do is address the message, add a subject heading, and send it, and I'm good to go. Here's another workflow. This one uses iCal to trigger a workflow. The idea here is that we're going to create a couple of folders and have Automator back up the contents of one to the other at the same time every day. So I'll start by creating a new folder on the desktop. I'm going to call it to backup. Then I'll open my key drive and I'll create a new folder there. Call it My Backups and flick down the triangle because we want to see what goes in that folder later on. Now let's return to Automator and I'll create a new workflow. This time I'm going to choose iCal Alarm and click on Choose. Now select Files and Folders. Select Get Specified Finder Items and drag it into the workflow. Then Get Folder Contents, drag that in. And finally, copy Finder Items and drag that in. Now save your workflow. I'll do that by pressing Command S. And save. And when you do that, iCal will launch and it will create a new event at the date and time that you created this workflow. We'll now edit this event. So I select it, press Command E. I'm going to have this repeat every day. So choose every day from the repeat menu. And then I want this to go off at 8 o'clock at night. So I enter 8 p.m. and I'll click on done. And as you can see, this event repeats every single day. Now quit iCal and I'll return to my workflow. Into the first action, drag your to backup folder. Go to the key drive and we'll take my backups and I'll drag that onto the pop-up menu in the third action. Now let's test the workflow to see if it actually does something. So I'll take my test file and I'll put it into the to backup folder. And there it is. Now I click run in my workflow and you can see what happens. It's taken the file that's in the to backup folder and it's been copied to my key drive. Now it would be a drag if you had to open your workflow every single day and click on this run button, but you don't need to. The beauty of an iCal alarm trigger is that you don't have to push the run button manually. Instead, iCal will simply trigger the workflow at the time I set within the event. And that's it. A couple of Automator workflows that I think you're going to find helpful. Thanks very much for watching.